In this video, we'll talk about syphilis, which is another relatively common sexually transmitted disease that presents with a range of symptoms, some of which are often mild and hard to notice. In its early stages, it is curable, but it can lead to disability, neurological diseases, and even death if not treated. Syphilis is an STI that is caused by the Treponema pallidum bacterium. T. pallidum is a spirochete that cannot survive outside of the human body for long periods of time. Transmission occurs from direct contact with infectious lesions when the bacteria enter the body through the mucous membranes or skin, usually during sexual contact. Syphilis can also spread from a mother with syphilis to her unborn baby, causing congenital syphilis. Rarely, it can be transmitted through needle stick and transfusion of infected blood. Within hours after entering the body, the bacteria reach the regional lymph nodes and rapidly spreads throughout the body. On average, 3.2% of antenatal care attendees test positive for syphilis. In pregnancy, it is the second leading cause of stillbirth globally and also results in prematurity, low birth weight, neonatal death, and infections in newborns. There have been reports in many countries of increasing trends. Untreated syphilis can lead to serious complications in 25% of infected individuals that do not receive diagnosis and treatment early enough. The complications can be severe and even life-threatening and can increase the risk of HIV acquisition and transmission. Usually, unsafe sexual practice is the most common risk factor for syphilis. Other risk factors are sharing needles, where an intravenous drug users can acquire syphilis from contaminated needle. Being born to a mother diagnosed with syphilis in pregnancy, and low social economic status. There are 4 stages of syphilis, which are primary, secondary, latent, and tertiary stages. The first stage is the primary stage. During the first or the primary stage, the earliest sign to occur about 3 to 4 weeks after acquiring infection is a single or multiple painless open sores called chancre. These sores usually occur in, on, or around the genitals, around the anus, the rectum and lips, or in the mouth. You may not notice the sore because it is painless. Whether or not you receive treatment, the sore normally lasts 3 to 6 weeks and heals. During the second stage, which is the secondary stage, sore throat and skin rashes emerge, with the rashes typically appearing on the palms or soles, but they can arise elsewhere on the body. Symptoms typically begin 6 to 12 weeks after the chancre appears. Tiredness, fever, sore throat, headaches, hoarseness, loss of appetite, and enlarged glands are all possible symptoms. Even if no treatment is received, these signs and symptoms will vanish after 2 to 6 weeks. Without the right treatment, your infection will move to the latent stage. The rashes disappear. It's a period when there are no visible signs or symptoms, and that's why it's also called the hidden stage. Even if the symptoms go away, syphilis infection persists and begins to damage the internal organs. This stage can span anywhere from 5 to 20 years. The fourth and last stage of syphilis is the tertiary stage. The majority of persons who have untreated syphilis do not progress to tertiary syphilis. When it does happen, though, it can damage a variety of organ systems. Tertiary syphilis is a severe form of the disease that develops 10 to 30 years after the first infection. In tertiary syphilis, the disease damages your internal organs like the heart. It can cause deafness, blindness, mental illness, memory loss, and destruction of soft tissues. Signs and symptoms vary from men to women and with each stage. Primary syphilis is characterized by chancre or syphilitic sore, which is single or multiple, painless, indurated, open sore. Chancres resolve within 3 to 6 weeks. The other symptom in primary syphilis is lymphadenopathy, or swollen lymph node that is regional to the site of the chancre. The symptoms of secondary syphilis are multisystemic. This stage usually begins with a rash on one or more areas of the body. Other symptoms are alopecia, which is patchy hair loss, sore throat, fever, headache, swollen lymph nodes, muscle aches, fatigue, and unexplained weight loss. In latent syphilis stage, there are no visible symptoms, but the bacteria continue to multiply and invade the organs. Tertiary stage is the late stage of syphilis, and symptoms would occur 10 to 30 years after your infection began. Symptoms might present as cardiovascular syphilis that is characterized by shortness of breath, palpitations, chest pain, and heart failure. It might also present as gammatous syphilis, which is very uncommon. It is characterized by presence of gamma, which are granulomatous nodules with central necrosis. This can occur on any part of the body. Other symptoms are neurosyphilis that presents with severe headache, muscle weakness, and changes of mental state. Ocular syphilis, which is characterized by eye pain, redness, and changes in your vision or even blindness. Autosyphilis that presents with hearing loss. Ringing, buzzing, roaring, or hissing in the ears, also known as tinnitus. And vertigo. Thorough history taking, physical examination, and laboratory tests help in making a diagnosis of syphilis. Non-treponemal serologic tests that measure IgG and IgM directed against a cardiolipin-lecithin cholesterol antigen complex. These tests include rapid plasma region and venereal disease research laboratory. Treponemal serologic tests that include agglutination assay and the fluorescent treponemal antibody absorbed test. It is important to keep in mind that the results from these tests remain positive even after successful treatment. Lumbar puncture is done for patients with syphilis and neurologic signs or symptoms or suspected treatment failure, and for HIV-infected patients with untreated syphilis of unknown or more than 1 year's duration. Dark field microscopy or immunofluorescence antibody staining of exudates from the lesions such as chancre are nowadays rarely used. It's also recommended that people who are sexually active be tested for sexually transmitted infections about once a year. Any patient with a diagnosis of syphilis should also be tested for HIV. In the early stages of syphilis, treatment can be successful. Patients with syphilis will often receive an intramuscular injection of penicillin G-benzathine during the primary, secondary, or tertiary stages. Multiple injections at weekly intervals are required for tertiary syphilis. To eradicate the bacteria from the central nervous system, neurosyphilis requires intravenous penicillin every 4 hours for 2 weeks. Always confirm the nature of the allergy in patients with a penicillin allergy. Alternative antibiotics such as doxycycline, ceftriaxone, azithromycin, or erythromycin can be administered in those who have a documented penicillin allergy. Without treatment, syphilis can lead to damage throughout your body. It increases the risk of HIV infection and can cause problems during pregnancy. Cardiovascular complications like damage to the heart valves. Neurological complications including stroke, meningitis, and dementia or memory loss. Hearing impairment and blindness might also occur. There is no vaccine for syphilis currently. Preventive measures to decrease the risk of syphilis include using condoms during sexual activity, abstaining from undesirable sexual practice. Limiting the number of one's sexual partners reduces the chances of being exposed. And avoiding alcohol and drugs that could potentially lead to unsafe sexual practices. And that is all for this video. If this video has been helpful, give it a like, share it, and hit the subscribe button. Thank you for watching. Until next time.